Sometimes we gotta see before we can be. So what I wanna do today is I'm gonna share with you what I did in my business that was gas on my fire. I visually had exactly who the people were that I was gonna be working with next in front of me, and it took my business to a whole other level. You know, we talk a lot in our business about staying top of mind for our clients, or our future clients especially. So what I want to do today is how do we keep them top of mind for us? What is it that we can do visually so that we make sure we focus on the biggest and the best people in our business? They're going to do business with us, odds are, the next in line. I used to do this in a very specific way. On my wall in front of where I sat at my desk, right in front of me, I always kept basically a poster board up there. You don't have to do it. There's a lot of ways to do this now, but I did it with an old school poster board, and I kept it. I called it my next 10 and best 10 list. And what this list looked like is that I had my next 10 people that I figured were going to be the people that were going to sell their home with me, that were going to list their home with me for sale. I also had on my next 10 list, it was the buyers that I figured were going to be the next 10 people to buy a house through me, or that I had the potential to represent them and work with them in their purchase. And then the top 10 list was the 10 people that were the closest and best clients that I had, the raving fans I had that either sent me referrals or that I knew were out there spreading my message that I was the agent of choice. This is really an opportunity for you to get visually in front of you everything that you need to see where your next 20 to 30 transactions are coming from. This can change your business in a dramatic way. I know that because it did mine. And what I want to do is I want to break each of these down to who should be on this list and how we should be communicating with them. Let's start with your next 10 listing clients that are on the board. I did this simple way. I tried to rank them basically from 1 to 10. I wanted to see who was it that had told me they were going to list their home in the next 6 months. Who was it that told me they were going to list their home in the next 3 months? I wanted to have this list. If I always had this list of 10 people that were considering selling, or that I felt like I had an opportunity to list their home for in the next 6 months, I felt like I had a pipeline that was full. By having these people listed up there, I kept a couple things up there. I did it this way. I had their name, I had their address, then the next thing I had was their estimated list price, and then I had, based on there, what the estimated commission that I would get from that sale, and then I had the last time that I talked to them on this list. I did it with basically just a poster board initially, and then I went to a whiteboard where I could make easy changes to this. So let me tell you what I wanted to do with this list. I wanted to have a couple things. I wanted to see what my pipeline was for potential business. So if I had 10 people and the average sales price was $800,000, I knew that I had a potential for $8 million worth of listings there. Now listen, I was doing other activities, so there were going to be listings, hopefully, that were going to pop up that I didn't expect were going to be there. But I knew that I had 10 people that were potentially opportunities for me. Didn't mean that I was going to get all of them, but it gave me the opportunity to keep them top of mind so that I stayed top of mind. Here's some of the things that I like to do for this seller list, because I'm going to break this down and give you some action steps once you've formulated this list that you can do on a weekly basis to make sure you're the agent of choice. All right, so if we're going to stay in touch with these sellers, there are certain things that we need to do, and we can systemize some of this. The first one is this. We need to have them set up where they're receiving emails on properties that come on the market, go under contract, or that are sold just like their house. This is giving them an immediate email as soon as something comes on the market that could affect the value of their property. Again, it keeps us top of mind. It also gives them information that's pertinent to their house. It also can cue them to give us a call to check up and see how this might affect their value. So the first thing is systemize, making sure that they're receiving updates on properties that are out there like theirs. The second thing is to make sure that we're having a personal conversation, text or email, to them at least once a week. That's why when I had it on my board, I kept up there last time I spoke to them, because then at a glance I could see who was it that I haven't spoken to in the last 7 days. Then I made sure that I kept those where it was at least in the last 7 days. Each of those 10 next potential listings I had, that I was going to have a personal touch with them. Now, this could be an email with the property. Hey, I saw this property, thought it would affect your value, wanted to give you an update on this. This could be a text of, hey, just checking in. Don't know if you saw this sale. Hey, was in the neighborhood, saw that y'all had whatever going on that you cleaned up the front yard. Whatever it is, it's a personal touch. It's staying in touch with them. When you stay in touch with them, it gives you the ability to understand there's not going to be any gaps here where maybe another agent comes in and tells them something and you miss out on that opportunity. Personally speaking with them develops the personal relationship. So make sure that's a part of this as we're keeping that top 10 and we're trying to stay top of mind. Number three is a monthly update on the market and properties affecting their value. This is something that I try to do every time. Now, think of it from this perspective. What affects a seller, or what are they curious about? They want to see, did the average price go up over the last month over what it was last month? They want to see the average number of sales there were this month versus last month. They want to see the list to sale price. How much was a house that was listed for sell in percentage wise to that listing? Also, we want to see, was there more inventory that came on the market? And last but not least, I want to let them know, how many days on market on average did that go up or down over the past month? You see, by giving them these details and telling them and letting them know how these affect them, it really gives you the ability to show yourself as the professional each and every month. Last but not least, while you're doing that monthly update on the market, I would do a separate email where I would give them an updated CMA, basically giving them a comparative market analysis of what their value is. I like to do this with video because it gives me the ability really to stress certain things, show them what's the most powerful tools that we've got to help them make sure that they maximize their price and they do it in the least amount of time. Also, it gives us the ability to highlight the properties that affect their value the most. Once we've done this, and now that you know that they're getting ready to sell, we do this on a monthly basis, this gives us slight adjustments to talk to them about where their value may have moved in just the last month. Is it a better time to sell? Hey, the days on market actually went up last month, so we're gonna probably need to price this more aggressively to make sure that we get it sold quicker if that's your main goal. Hey, the price has actually moved up 2%. So where we were last month, we actually have a little more room to move your price up if we were to put it on the market now instead of when we would have possibly put it on about 30 days ago. You see, by communicating the value here, giving them an update, this is the most important thing they want to know, is how much will my house sell for and what can I expect as far as the market is concerned right now. When you do these things, I promise you those 10, you're going to get a high percentage of those that you're going to be the agent of choice. The second top 10 list I had were the next 10 buyers that I had the potential to sell a home to. These are people that I wanted to make sure were moving down the process. Again, I want to break this down into a few things that we want to do, but let's think of it this way. What are the things that buyers want to know about? That's what I'm going to go over now, because these are the things we're going to give them in the way of value on a consistent basis. The first one is this. We want to have an automated system that will email them immediately as soon as a property comes on the market that meets their criteria. So once we've done our consultation with them, once we've got an idea of the area and we've gotten them pre-qualified, pre-approved, and we know that they're looking for a certain price range in a certain area, now we want to make sure that systematically, whether it's through your MLS or through your website, we have it set up where they will immediately get emailed as soon as something comes on the market meeting this. You want to have a little call to action in this also. Hey, if you'd like more information about this property, reach out to me and I'll be glad to gather in as much information as quick as possible, or get us in the house if you'd like to take a look at it. You see, when you have a call to action on the end of there, one that pops up immediately, you're the first one to get some of that information, and they're the first one that they will call as well. Secondly, we want to have a personal touch at least once a week. If we're in this position where we have buyers that are ready, willing, and able, if we can find them the right property, the worst thing we can do is not talk to them for 3 or 4 weeks, because someone is probably going to be letting them know about other properties. So I had that again. When I had the buyers up on my board, basically I had the buyer's name, the potential sales price of what they were looking to buy. I wanted to talk to them about, had they been pre-approved? I wanted to see what the time frame was, and I wanted to see what was the net that I could possibly make off this, because I wanted to have basically a systematic pattern, just like I did with the listing side, of what it was. Now, I want to also, and that's what I want to highlight here, the last thing I had on there was the last contact I had. Again, having a whiteboard in front of you where you can adjust these each time you talk to someone really helps you stay organized with this. What I wanted to do is to have a personalized. I might text them and say, hey, I emailed over that new property that hit the market. Just wanted to check and make sure you received it. That could be a personalized touch. Could be a phone call where you're just checking in and saying, hey, just wanted to check and see if you guys saw anything else that might interest you out on the market, or if anything's changed. Taking the time to personally speak with them on a weekly basis, make sure that you not only stay top of mind, but you become the agent of choice that builds a relationship that not only bears this particular purchase they have, but you become their agent for life. The third thing I like to do on a weekly basis, and in worst case, on a monthly basis, depending on how close they were to being ready to buy, was any updates on interest rates, how that might affect their purchase price, and also how it might affect their monthly payment that they have. You know, we're in an environment where rates right now are bouncing around, but odds are they're going up. So each and every week, if I was giving someone an update and I was saying, hey, the rates moved from 3% to 3.25%, this affects you in a monthly basis based on your $450,000 purchase price or $1 million purchase price, whatever it is. This means that your payment based on this 3.25 would be X versus what it was last month at Y when it was at 3%. You see, when you give them the differences, now they're actively understanding what the value is of finding the right place as quick as possible. Create some urgency, also gives them the information they need to make sure that they know everything that's going on in the market so you can be the professional that you've been designed to be. Last but not least, on a monthly basis, we want to give them an update on the current market for homes like they're looking at. So if they have a price range, I'm just going to use this number. If they got a price range between $500,000 and $600,000, what I want to do is at the end of the month, I want to come on and I want to see how many homes are on the market between $500,000 and $600,000 now. I want to compare the inventory last month versus what's available now. Then I want to give them kind of an update on this. Based on this, this gives you the understanding that if we have more houses for sale now, that maybe as a buyer, we're getting more opportunities. Also, I want to concentrate on a couple things. The average sales price. I want to show them what the prices are doing. Are they moving to their advantage where they've drifted down a little bit last month? Or are they moving up a little bit? Whatever it is, I want to give them that information. I also want to talk to them about the average list to sale price on things that have closed. Because if we're at a place where we see that the average list of sales price is 99%, which it has been for a while now, and now all of a sudden we see that last month, the negotiations went to where it was 97%, now we can talk to them about the fact that, hey, the market appears to be softening a little bit with what's out there, so we may have a little more room for negotiation. See, when we start talking to them about the things that are pertinent to them, all of a sudden this value we're adding is different from anything they're hearing from anyone else, and it secures that relationship in a way that we know we're gonna be the agent of choice. The third group that I had was my next top 10 list. And these were top 10. These were people that had referred me business, past clients, people that I knew were raving fans and were sharing the message that I was the agent of choice to everyone they came into contact with. I wanted to really make sure that I secured these relationships. A little bit different here. I wasn't wanting to talk to them every week necessarily. Depending on the relationship, it was about every 2 weeks or once a month. I also wanted to make sure that I was rotating people in and rotating people out. Or in a lot of cases, when my business was really good, I was adding people instead of removing people, and that became a top 20 list. Here's what I wanted to do with this group. I wanted to make sure that I stayed top of mind for them in a couple of ways. The first one was this. I wanted to have personal communication with them at least once a month. I wanted to make sure that they knew how much I appreciated them. I would just check in, hey, saw that you posted about so-and-so on Facebook. Looks like you had a great time. Something that was a personal message to them. Hey, just was in the neighborhood. Looks like you guys are doing really well. Or whatever it is, reach out to them. How's the family doing? Hey, are you guys still loving your house? Hey, thanks for mentioning me to so-and-so. So whatever it is, make sure that once a month you're having that personal touch with them. The second thing is this, systematically give them information about their home. Odds are if they're a great client, they're a homeowner. There's someone that's in the market that is actually owns a house. Monthly, I would have it where it would email them updates on properties that have come on the market, gone under contract, or that have sold in like their house so that they know how it affects their value. Again, it's just reminding them we're in real estate, giving them something of value, and deepening that relationship. The third tool I like to use with these folks because they're homeowners is HomeBot. HomeBot is an app that gives them basically the ability to get a full detailed description of their home's value, what the amount of equity they have, what they could do if they were to refinance, what opportunities they might have with that equity. It is the most detailed report I've ever seen. It also is something that has about a 70% open rate because of how good the details are in this report. I would encourage you, if you haven't got HomeBot, make sure that your top referrals, your past clients are involved in this, and it is a definite opportunity for you to have additional conversations and to add true value to that top 10 list. Last but not least, at least once a quarter, I want to surprise them with something that's unexpected. I want to give them something of value. This could be tickets to an event in your area. This could be something as simple as a gift card with a handwritten note of, hey, just wanted to say thanks for all that you've done to help me grow my business. I really appreciate you keeping me top of mind and continuing to send people my way. You see, when you do things unexpected, it doesn't have to be that huge. It could be something you do on the anniversary of their house that they bought. Maybe it's sending them a cake or cookies or something just to recognize them for all that they do. When you do those things, you're creating this environment where they want to reciprocate. They want to send people your way. And now not only are you staying top of mind, but they're looking for ways to add value to your business. You see, if you'll do these things, if you'll have your next 10 listings that are coming and you keep that information in front of you and you add value to them, you have your next 10 potential buyers right in front of you where you're constantly adding value to them on a weekly basis, talking to them personally, and then you've got your top 10 list that you're surprising with understanding exactly the value that they have in your business by giving them information, giving them value, and saying thank you consistently, I promise your business can't help but grow. I hope this has been helpful, and I'll talk to you soon.
Thanks for watching the video. I specifically chose the video below for you because it builds on the one you just watched. I hope it's helpful, and I'll talk to you soon.